Tanya Madison, and welcome to Law Unfiltered, where I discuss current events and some of the legal implications. Recently, Equifax has been in the news because they recently incurred a breach of a lot of consumers' credit cards and other personal information, and understandably, people are upset. And they have subsequently since been hit with a lot of class action suits. There's one here in Georgia, but there's also one in Oregon, and that's the one I kind of want to break down. So in Oregon, pretty much the people are saying not only did you breach your duty of negligence, but you also capitalized on our harm. In other words, you failed to tell us as soon as you knew our personal information was being exposed because you wanted to sell or dissolve some of your stock to ensure that you still got a profit on that. And they're talking about some of the executives and officers that immediately did dissolve their stock before announcing to the public that, hey, there's been a breach. Now, this isn't the first time a company has been in the news because of a breach. If you may remember, back in 2013, Target had a similar incident occur during the holiday season when their debit and credit card information of several consumers was leaked and hijacked. And then similarly, they suffered a lawsuit, a class action lawsuit, that ultimately settled actually earlier this year. And pretty much what you had to do was sign up or go to Target and say, this is my damage, this is the loss that I incurred, and whether that is having to pay late fees on a credit card or whether that was actually having to pay some of those expenses that were incurred not by you but because of the breach, or whether that was monitoring, and that's the time, or spending money on software to monitor your credit information. And so in this case, what the plaintiffs are alleging is, I've already had to incur a loss because I had to get software or some type of system put in place to monitor if my information has been leaked. But of course, they're also going to make claims and hoping to bring in more people in the action of even the time that it took to go to the credit card people and cancel whatever information I needed to cancel, or go wherever it needed to happen to be able to prevent or remedy the result of the breach. They're going to put that into their losses. So I'd imagine that Equifax is going to at some point settle this. It's not a good PR look to have them pretty much not only have leaked over 140 million people's personal information, but also the fact that they did dissolve of their shares. They did know about it at least months before they told the public, and they had opportunities to put in high level or at least medium level securities in place to try to combat or prevent such breaches, and they didn't do so. I'd imagine that they're probably going to settle it. So if you're one of the people that are affected by this, definitely keep an eye out for it. And if it does settle, do know that you as an individual is then responsible for making sure you've documented all your losses or all your damages, and then, of course, assert them later on. So thanks so much for tuning in, and I will catch you next time on Law Unfiltered.